Now that you have learned how to create a low-poly column and sell the illusion of detail with normal maps, let's see it in context. Open the file named memorial.max you downloaded for this tutorial. The design you see is very much based on the Civic Center in Denver, Colorado. The architectural structure contains 60 columns, like the one you learned to create in this tutorial. Additionally, some other models were created using the same techniques. These include the beam parts above the columns and the roof itself. If you want to explore these objects separately, then you can open the file named top.max. There you will see the high poly and low poly objects side by side so you can compare poly counts. You'll also find several floating objects that were used to convey more detail, much like you use for the column itself. The ceiling and sloped roof are of the same poly count, only the use of maps sell the illusion of detail. Going back to the memorial scene, note that the center arch section was also built using the same techniques. The colonnades were put together by arraying and duplicating the columns and the other parts. They were then grouped together and bent as a single object. No mirroring or symmetry modifiers were used on the columns, so that it doesn't mess with the engraved SPQR text. The same goes for the lower beams, so that the repeating pattern doesn't change directions. The upper beams and roof, on the other hand, didn't have those limitations, so the symmetry modifier was used for duplication. Corner beams were sliced at 45-degree angles for a better fit. Once all the elements were in place, they were grouped together using the group command. And once that was done, a bend modifier was applied, and its values adjusted accordingly. It is worth noting that the bend modifier's center location was relocated to have the group bend from the arch's wall. Each colonnade group has 28 columns, and in addition to the other parts, we're still at a meager 34,000 polys per colonnade. The whole scene, for that matter, which includes the colonnades, the center arch, the pool, terrain, and other odd bits, still stands at a very respectable 77,000 polys, which is a fraction of what 60 high-resolution columns would have totaled. Those would have resulted in over 4 million polygons, 60 columns times 67,000 polys, not taking into account the rest of the scene. Rendering time would have also been affected. As it stands, this scene shouldn't take more than a minute or two to render a still frame at 720p. There are various camera angles already set. Try to render one or two to see the results. Even those close-up shots give you excellent results by selling the illusion of detail. This about wraps up this tutorial. In it, you have learned how to create convincing-looking models with low polygon counts. You learn how to do this by extracting models from high-poly models, properly unwrapping texture coordinates, and ultimately extracting normal map data through a process called render to texture. I hope you enjoyed the series, and we'll come back to you with more tutorials soon. This is Amer Yassin from Autodesk, wishing you a good day.